implement far-reaching reforms to ensure the government achieves universal health coverage. Kagwe said should he be confirmed to the position, he will push amendments to the NHIF Act to make contributions mandatory. Mutahi Kagwe also challenged state officers to seek services in local hospitals, saying such a move will ensure the facilities provide quality health care to all Kenyans. At the same time, Betty Miner was vetted for the top seat in the Ministry of Industrialization, Trade and Enterprise Development. Trade Principal Secretary nominee Johnson Weru will have to be cleared by the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission before he can assume that position.
The National Assembly Committee on Appointments vetted former Nyeri Senator Mutahi Kagwe, who has been nominated by President Uhuru Kenyatta for appointment as Cabinet Secretary for Health. Should Parliament confirm his nomination, Kagwe will steer universal health coverage, one of the four key pillars of President Uhuru Kenyatta's legacy to provide citizens with affordable health care by 2022.
How do we implement universal health care when NHIF is in crisis? This is not a place where one goes to win a popularity contest. This is a place where one goes to execute a responsibility that Kenyans intend that it be done. If you look at the countries that have moved to success in universal healthcare, they have moved a lot of voluntary contributions to mandatory contributions. And Mr. Chairman, I will be seeking the support of this House in legislation. Would you be looking at a situation where you, as a cabinet secretary, if you are approved, or myself as a member of parliament who is earning well above half a million shillings, I am able to contribute a little more than just the 1,700 shillings that would help that young Kenyan who is unemployed, who is not able to contribute this 500 or 600 shillings per month?
Mutahi says time is ripe for state officers to start seeking medical care in public hospitals in order to improve quality of service.
The measure of a success of a system in a country is how much confidence the citizens have in public facilities.
The monies contributed to NHIF should be for purposes of assisting the country in improving the healthcare.
We must make sure that the monies that the government is paying to private sector insurances is paid to NHIF pool.
The subject of corruption at the Minister of Health was highlighted.
How will you overcome the cartels that are in the health sector to the point that they later end up fighting you because you are stepping on them, or you get sucked right in?
You must be convinced in yourself that you are not going to be part and parcel of that mafia.
Betty Chemutai Maina.
Outgoing Principal Secretary for Environment and Forestry, Betty Maina, was also vetted. She is the designated Cabinet Secretary for Industrialization, Trade and Enterprise Development. Should Parliament confirm her nomination, she will shepherd the manufacturing agenda, which is currently taking a hit from high operating costs, high electricity costs, and heavy taxation burden.
The government is saying they are creating an enabling and friendly business environment. But yet, multinationals are moving away from Kenya.
Trade Principal Secretary nominee Johnson Weru appeared before the National Assembly's Trade Committee without a clearance letter from the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission. According to EACC's communication to Parliament,